We had a really an incredible month on the Syrian front. The president said, I want to marshal Congress for a strike. Then he backed down from that. And on the Iranian front, he was snubbed by the president last week of Iran in the UN, but then he came back with a phone call. What does the world think about all of this? What are your sources telling you about this extraordinary month in foreign policy?
I was, the UN General Assembly convened in the past 10 days, and so I live in New York, and I was here a lot speaking to those in foreign policy, diplomats, foreign leaders, and the big takeaway I had is that so many of these leaders are a little concussed still about what they see as America's less sure position in the past few years. They're not as clear on American leadership and American capability, actually. At the same time, I think I correctly observed a diminution in our current president's stature. People are not saying, what does the president think, the way they used to. One of the people I spoke to had spent considerable time at a meeting with the new president of Iran. And I spoke to my friend afterwards, and I said, so what did he say about Obama? And he said, that subject didn't even come up. It was like, that's not that interesting. You know,
when we talk about how America...
It's an odd thing. Well, I've never seen this.
It's disturbing. I was disturbed when I read your column. Yeah. It's almost like the incredible shrinking president. When we talk about the leaders' perceptions of American presidents, we often think of our great allies, our European allies, or our great foes, say... today, maybe that's China, Russia. But we often forget the Middle East, and that's the region that's really aflame right now. Do you have a sense of how our Middle Eastern allies are viewing, outside of Israel, I'm talking Saudi Arabia and these kinds of countries, are viewing these overtures to Iran?
I think with the overtures to Iran, I suppose there are mixed views in the Mideast, but I'll tell you, the Syria flop, if you will, the sense that the president was unsure through the Syria crisis, and he was like this at first, and then like this at first, then let Congress do it, and then was engulfed with the opinion of the American people, as Congress was too. Everybody was surprised by that, by the calls and the emails that were 90-1. We don't want this right now.
The president never explained
it. That left things sort of startled. What's the first? People were a little bit back on their feet still over that. It was only a few weeks ago, and the UN started coming together about a week ago. So you can sort of feel that in the air as generally understood to be an embarrassment that yet may end relatively happily. Who knows? There's a lot of mystery around it.
Well, let's hope it ends happily.
Want to end with optimism here.
Let's end with optimism. I know. It is Monday. Let's be optimistic. Declarations columnist Peggy Noonan, thank you so much for being on.
Thank you, Mary.